A Minnesota couple has written a book about the year they spent in the Boundary Waters Canoe Area. From September 2015 to September 2016, Amy and Dave Freeman camped at 120 sites and traveled more than 2,000 miles by canoe, foot, ski, snowshoe, and dog team. It was all part of the campaign to save the Boundary Waters from proposed sulfide copper ore mining on the edge of the wilderness area. Their new book, which is available everywhere books are sold, is entitled A Year in the Wilderness. And Dave and Amy Freeman are joining us now. Thank you so much for coming in.
Oh, thanks for having us.
The number one question I've got when I told people I was going to have you on, are you still married and how did you survive a year with just the two of you? With all due respect.
We're still married. Yes.
We survived.
Yeah, you know, I think our relationship is actually better when we're out there because we have to deal with problems right away. We can't let things build. And that's been really good for our relationship.
All right. And the book is filled with beautiful pictures that we're looking at, most of which you took, Dave. Mm-hmm. Let me ask you, you both are guides, so this is not something new, but was it different being out there that long?
It was different, yeah. Well, being in the shoulder seasons was new for us, being out there in the fall as the ice was forming and then in the spring when the ice was going away. And also we noticed different things happening to us. Like I think our senses were more attuned to what was going on around us, right. Both hearing and scent.
Right. Never heard that term shoulder season, but you mentioned, Dave, though, even after 8 months, you were developing a new sense of scent.
Oh my gosh, we could smell the soap on people when they canoed by. We smelled wild rice for the first time. We were noticing things we had never noticed, even after spending a month or more in the wilderness.
Okay. Now, you did have people coming in to help you with supplies, but most of the time you were on your own. I understand there was only one really dangerous moment.
Yeah, Dave actually fell through the ice. It was in that sort of in-between time we were waiting for the ice to freeze on a lake where, you know, we were waiting to get close to the edge so we could receive a resupply, actually, but we needed the ice to form in a solid way. So we went out to check the ice edge. It was just a gorgeous day when the ice, like the water was kind of churned up by wind. And Dave was setting up the camera to take a picture. And I noticed the ice under him just like started to sag, and then he felt it and he did this amazing dive and threw the camera at the same time and managed to only get wet like up to his waist basically.
All right, and you actually were never sick because I asked you about any kind of medical ailments.
Not even a cold. We couldn't believe it.
All right, and you did this because you want to call attention to the Boundary Waters. Tell us about that.
The Boundary Waters is a very special place. It's our nation's most popular wilderness, and a series of copper sulfide ore mines are being proposed right on the edge of the wilderness, and it's really important that we protect it. There's an important environmental review going on right now, and there's pressure from some folks to try and stop that review from happening. It's critical that we make our voices heard and make sure that 2-year review goes forward.
Now, you know, I asked you, an obvious question is like, how did you adjust to this, you know, being in the wilderness? I also asked you about how it was difficult. It was apparently difficult to adjust being out of the wilderness after a year. Tell us about that.
That's right. It was a tough transition. We were actually more nervous about leaving the wilderness than we had been about going into it for a whole year. And I think the toughest thing for us was sleeping in a building, just being away from the sound of water lapping on shore or the wind in the trees, stuff like that.
All right. Well, the book, as I said, is available everywhere books are sold. Congratulations. I'm glad that you are still very happily married, and it's a beautiful book with beautiful pictures.
Thank you.